My name is Graham Eichmiller. I'm from the University of Wisconsin-Platteville. I am a senior and I am majoring in manufacturing technology management. What I really enjoy about using the CNC machines as well as the other equipment in our lab here at the University of Platteville is just coming here knowing that we're going to take something and turn it into a better something, so to speak. As it pertains to the CNC machines, let's say we're making a pattern. We start with an idea. It goes to the computer. We'll program it, and we'll make a block of pattern board come to life and turn into a pattern that will eventually make the end part out in our foundry. So as part of our drafting classes and casting classes here at the university, we were given a project to make some window hardware for historical restoration. And so where it all began is we got the original pieces, and the drafting class was in charge of redrawing these pieces and really making life to it. We had to come up with our own thread system. It's a rounded thread system that isn't classified really anywhere, and so we had to do that and then remake this window piece. And we had to make sure as we were redesigning these that they were very close to the original model, as this is a restoration, so the accuracy was important to us and the end user. So after successfully recreating these parts using our CAD systems here, we made sure for the manufacturability in the foundry that we added the correct features such as draft and worked out the gating and mold flow type of stuff. And with that, then we created the patterns for these. And so that was put into place, and then machine programs were made for those, and that in the end, we got our patterns to use in order to make these parts. And so what we did is we actually made up some prototype pieces, and we were able to look at what the end product would be like. How this window hardware works is that one of these pieces gets fastened into the sill of the window, and the other piece is mounted on the window sill. And what you have is this screw that's held in here with a small piece of wire inside. And what happens is when the window comes to close, this screw catches in this that's in the window itself, and then the window gets screwed shut and tightened, and that's how it shuts the window. So after you've unscrewed it completely, then the window can go up, and the window has to pivot in here, which is another reason why these threads had to have a certain amount of tolerance, because it's on that radius. So these are the patterns themselves. They're a little dirty. We have the graphite on them, which helps release the pattern from the sand itself. These are what were manufactured. You'll see here, these were the individual parts machined onto the pattern. You can see you have two sides to it. And then this is some of the gating associated with it, and that was done on the inserts themselves. And then something that was done later after doing some mold flow analysis would be the runner on the pattern itself here. And so what really excites me about this piece is just the fact that we were given a piece to reverse engineer. We had to make it look just like it. We had to go and cast it in our foundry here. And it's amazing that we were able to accomplish casting these male and female threads. That's really the big pull away from it, was that we were able to make the cores that were necessary. What really drives me to do this is just my background in manufacturing, just growing up working on all sorts of things with trucks, go-karts, racing, dirt bikes, four-wheelers, stuff of that nature. The mechanical stuff is really what fuels me to come here and build things as well as most of the other kids in this program.